Cloudflare just got a whole lot friendlier for AI agents. With the launch of remote MCP authorization support from Stitch, developers can now build fully agent-accessible apps on Cloudflare Workers and do it securely using OAuth 2.0. If you've been following along, this is a buzzword, MCP, or Model Context Protocol from Anthropic, is an open standard that lets LLMs interact with third-party apps. We can have LLM only, and think, instead of hard coding, every tool, every integration, agents can dynamically discover and interact with your app. So we have LLMs and MCP, and we go LLM, hits MCP server, hits services. So you can call APIs, submit forms, or run workflows, all using a standard protocol. Okay. Why does this matter? Originally, MCP servers were local only, cool for demos, not super useful on the internet. Cloudflare's recent Workers MCP package changes that all. It gives you everything you need to stand up remote MCP servers at the edge, real-time bidirectional communication, state management for multi-step tasks, built-in support for the remote MCP spec, but until now, authorization was still the missing piece. That's where Stitch comes in. With full support for OAuth 2.0 and Dynamic Client Registration, or DCR, so agents can securely act on behalf of users with proper scopes and consent. Very important. What can developers do with this, you ask? If you're building on Cloudflare Workers, you can now make your app accessible to AI agents using remote MCP, let agents trigger real workflows on behalf of users, handle auth securely with OAuth 2.0, support DCR so agents can register themselves, no manual config. Keep everything fast, secure, and running at the edge, which is what Cloudflare does pretty well. Basically, it unlocks a clean, standards-based way to let agents interact with your app. No weird hacks, no reinventing auth. Why should developers care? This makes it remote MCP production ready, not just a toy spec. So that's the high-level view. Cloudflare Workers gives you the infrastructure to run remote MCP servers globally. Stitch handles all the hard parts of auth and client registration, and together, they make it really straightforward to build agent-accessible apps. Here, locally, we have our MCP client, and these can be browsers, assistants, and apps. When it wants to interact with an app, it sends a request over the MCP protocol to our Cloudflare-hosted server on the internet. Server. And we have MCP in the middle. And Cloudflare also handles our API routes and even the front end. Durable objects handle the stateful part of the MCP interaction. Meanwhile, we have Stitch handling auth with some endpoints and third-party services and integrations. So everything is fast, distributed, and secure, but also fully agent-aware. Okay, let's see this all in action. Stitch wrote this very helpful blog post that I will be linking, and it also links to this very helpful demo application. A to-do list, we have a static website built with React and Vite on top of Workers assets, a REST API built using Hono on top of Workers KV, key value, and a MCP server built on top of and using Cloudflare durable objects. So let's set it up. Follow these steps. Create a Stitch account, which I have done. And let's create a new project. Let's call this MCP video. That was an equal sign. MCP video. And this has to be a consumer authentication, not B2B SaaS. I did that the first time. Oops, okay. And let's go to project details. MCP video. And we're going to use these tokens very soon. Keys, tokens. And first off, we're going to git clone the app, and we're going to open it. And this is Cursor. I'm in my demos directory. I'm going to open this terminal, cd it in. Let's install our dependencies. Very nice. After npmi, what do? We copy .env.template to env.env.local. And let's add our Stitch public token from the dashboard. .env local public token. Ha ha ha. Naming things is hard, but that was very helpful. That name. It's like, what do I grab? Public token. They did not hide it, so I'm not gonna hide it either. Yay. I added that, and then create .dev.vars by copying .dev.vars.template. Stitch project ID and secret. I'm gonna add Stitch secret, but you can't see it. Okay. So I'm back in .env.local. You'll have to trust me that my .dev.vars has both my project ID and my secret. Run it locally, npm run dev. Of course, you can also deploy it on Cloudflare Workers. We're gonna run our app locally. Add it as an allowed domain for the Stitch SDK. Enable SDK and test. Yeah, I should have followed that direction in the hub repo readme. But now I have it. I'm gonna connect with Google. Gonna use my work email, and you also see my private email, personal. To-do items shown can be edited via the UI and the REST API or via the MCP server. Connect to the MCP server running at localhost 3000/SSE with your MCP client to try it out. First off, let's add make MCP video, add to-do. Very nice. And it's saved. I just refreshed. Call mom. I should call my mom. Hi, mom. These are not completed, so not gonna complete or delete them. Where was it? Yes, here. It says test your MCP server using the MCP inspector. So let's make a new terminal and run that. Up and running. Okay, very nice, an MCP inspector. So we can see requests and more. So I can't wait to see what you cook up with MCP, Cloudflare Workers, and Stitch.